This is a literature class, English literature, and from today onwards, I'm going to begin act number 2, scene number 1 of your drama, The Merchant of Venice. So act number 2, scene number 1, and I'd like to say you, when we are doing this or when you'll be listening this particular clip of video, please keep a pencil ready and note down the word meaning very carefully, because this may not be possible to write the meaning of every difficult word there on the board. So this is act number 2, scene number 1. On my book it's on page number 56, it may differ on yours. So this is act number 2, scene number 1, Belmont. The place is Belmont. Belmont is the place of Portia. If all the scenes in the previous act took place in Venice, this time the scene begins in a place called Belmont, and this is Portia's palace. The exact location is a room in Portia's house, flourish of cornets. This is a musical instrument played especially in the past when the lord and the lady of the land used to enter into the scene. And here, who enters into the scene is the Prince of Morocco and his train. Train here means followers. Train means followers. So the Prince of Morocco has come along with followers. Portia and Erisa and other attendants are of course there. Other attendants here are the servants, the maids. They were present there. So when this scene begins, Morocco has come to make the choice. The purpose of Morocco coming to this scene is to make the choice. He is the first one in this drama to come and make the choice. If you have forgotten, then let me remind you, Portia is to get married. And the way she will get married has been already designed by her late father. Her father is dead. And the process by means of which Portia will be married is, there will be three caskets made of gold, silver and lead, and whoever will come and choose the correct casket will get Portia. So this is the way Portia will get married. And now the first person in this drama who has come to marry Portia is Morocco. So without wasting much time, let us move on to the text of this scene. So here we are in act number 2, scene number 1, line number 1. Morocco says, "Mislike me not for my complexion, the shadowed livery of the burnished sun, to whom I am a neighbor and near bred. Bring me the fairest creature northward born, where fever's fires scarce cause the icicles. And let us make incision for our love, to prove whose blood is reddest, his or mine. I tell thee, lady, this aspect of mine hath feared the valiant. By my love, I swear, the best regarded virgins of our clime have loved it too. I would not change this hue, except to steal your thoughts, my gentle queen." So this is the first person speaking in this scene. Morocco, you can say Prince of Morocco, is the first person who has started this scene. His purpose is to come and woo Portia. His purpose is to choose the one of the caskets which he feels is correct, and hence marry Portia. His complexion is not good. He is dark complexioned, and it is not his fault. It is because he belongs to such a place which receives plenty of heat, and that has burned his color. At the very beginning, he says, "Mislike me not for my complexion." Mislike means dislike. Dislike me not for my complexion. Complexion means the looks. We know the Prince of Morocco is not a handsome man. He is not a very attractive person. He is little darker in his looks. And he is quite aware of this. So he says, please do not hate me. Mislike means hate. Please do not hate me because of my looks. Because he knows that he is not a man with a handsome look. The shadowed livery of the burnished sun. Second line. The shadowed livery. Shadowed is the dark and livery is the color. The dark color of his skin is because of the burnished sun. Burnished means very, very bright sun. So why is he dark? He is dark because of the bright. He is dark because of the bright sun. The excessive heat has burnt his color. And because of that, he is dark. But at the very beginning of this scene, he is requesting Portia not to hate him because of the look. Because he feels that there are so many other qualities in him for which Portia should fall in love. And Portia should give importance to his other aspects. He says, to whom I am a neighbor and near bred. To whom means to that place. He is a neighbor means, he means to say. He is born and brought up in such a place, in that place, where the people receive plenty of the burnished sun, and that is burnt everybody in their color. Near bred means close relation. I belong to such a place which receives plenty of heat, and because of that reason, it has burnt everybody in their color, and I am also a little dark. Then, this is the first three lines. He is requesting Portia not to hate him. But in the very next line, he has started challenging everybody. Now he tries to bring out the good quality, the positive aspect that he has in him. He says, bring me the fairest creature northward born. Fairest creature means the handsome man. Bring the most handsome man born in the north. Why not? Because north receives very little heat and the people there are very, very fair looking. And bring them and compare them with me. Okay, now in what way should they be compared? Comparison should not be in terms of the looks. Comparison should be in terms of the quality they have in them. He says, bring me the fairest creature northward born, where Phoebus fire scarce falls the icicles. Where means in that north place, the place receives so little of light or the heat of the sun, that there is no power in the heat of the sun even to melt the ice. This is why the place always remains covered with the ice. Because even the sun fails to melt the ice. And it is not the strength or the power of the ice, but it is the weakness of the sun. So the people are not born there because in their skin by the sun. So the people obviously and naturally they are white and fair looking. They are handsome. So he says, bring me the most handsome man born in the north and then compare us. And let us make incision for your love. Incision is a cut. And make us incision for your love means you taste our love. You compare two of us, myself and the man who is born in the north. You bring and compare us who loves you more. To prove whose blood is reddest, his or mine. And then compare. Compare mine. You make incision. Let the blood ooze out from my body. And do the same thing to the man who was born in the north and whom you have brought here. Make incision on his body as well. And then let the blood ooze out and then compare the blood. And see whose blood is more redder, his or mine. Now what is the reference of this redder blood? Remember, this drama was written in the early part of the 17th century. Or you can say in the 16th and 17th century, early part of the 17th century. And those days the Elizabethans in England, Queen Elizabeth, this is the period of Queen Elizabeth in England. Those days they believed a person who had thicker or redder blood were passionate lovers. If my blood is thin, then I'm very weak in love. But if my blood is very thick and redder, then I'm supposed to be very, very passionate in my love. Bring the man from the north, the most handsome man. Make incision on his body. Let the blood ooze out and then compare the blood. And then see whose blood is more redder, his or mine. He mean to say, he will find my blood to be more redder. So he mean to say, though outwardly I may not be very handsome, but I love you more passionately. I love you sincerely. And I love you more than any man born in the north or any handsome man. I tell thee, lady, this aspect of mine, this aspect means this quality of mine, hath fear the valiant. This quality of mine even creates fear in the heart of the valiant. Valiant means the courageous man, the people who consider themselves to be very, very brave. Even the bravest man, when they look at me, my presence is enough to create a chill in their heart. Even the valiant or the bravest one are scared of my look. By my love I swear, the best regarded virgin of our clime have loved it too. Even the best regarded virgins, the best regarded virgins are the most beautiful ladies of my clime, means of my climate, of my place. He speaks about the girls of the country called Morocco, and he says that the girls of the of Morocco are all likes me. They all like me. They all want to marry me. I will not change my hue. Hue means color, complexion. I'm not ready to change my complexion. Except to steal your thoughts. Except to steal your thoughts means except to win your opinion, my gentle queen. And he's so confident that at the end he has regarded Portia as his queen. So this is the first 12 lines. I write here line number 01 to 12. This is an explanation of the first 12 lines. Dear children, I have not written the word meaning. So many word meanings on the board here. I have written only a few, but I have explained the word meaning of the words, every difficult word here. And when you listen to this or when you see this video clip, please hold a pencil ready and write the word meaning there on the book itself, so that when you do the reading, understanding will be very easy for you. So this is the beginning of this scene. We stop here, and the next few lines will be sent to you in the next video. Thank you, dear children.